Hi everybody and welcome to my tutorials. In this tutorial, I'll be teaching how to make a login form in the terminal in Python. So let's get started. So now let me show you what we'll be creating in this tutorial. So as you see in the terminal, it asks me to select an option. So if I want to sign up, I type in S, and if I want to log in, I type in L. So first of all, I need to sign up in order to log in, so S, and then create a username. So the username I'll create will be BM, and then the user password will be 123. And then after I do this, it will print account created successfully. And after this, it will give me this option again to select an option. So now I want to log in. Enter the username I just created, and if you get it wrong, it will print user not found. So let's put in the username, and then enter user password, and then after that, it will print logged in. So it's not that complicated to create this, it's only like 30 lines of code. So let's get started. So the first thing we need to do is we need to print the options for the user. So we'll print select an option. So parentheses, and we'll put in L for login. And then I'll put in this tube symbol. I think it's over the enter key. And then I'll put in S. Sign up. So after you do this, you want to get the user's answer. So we'll input, and we'll leave this input blank, and I'll put this in a variable. And after this, we need to check what the user's answer was. So first of all, we want to say if answer is equal to S. So if the user answered us with an S, so first of all, we want to input create username. And I'll put this in the variable as well. And I'll create another input that will ask for the password. Create user password. So after the user signs up, we want to print account created successfully. Okay. So after we do this, we want to give the user an option to log in. So I'll copy the code from up here and I'll paste it down here. And I'll add a backslash n, and this will just push this text over here to the next line. So this is pretty much it for the sign up. So now we want to elif answer is equal to L. So this means the user wants to log in. So first of all, we need to create an input that will ask for the user's name. So input enter user name, and then we have to input enter user password. Okay, so after you do this, we need to check if the username or the password is wrong. So we'll say while ul is not equal to the variable we created here, so u. So after we do this, we want to print, let's say user not found. And after this, I need to copy the first option again and paste it down here. And after we do this, we need to check if the password is wrong. So if the password is wrong, so while lp is not equal to p, And this is the variable where the password is saved. So if the password is wrong, you want to print password incorrect. Typo, incorrect. So if the user responds with anything else than S and L, we want to print error. And after we print error, we want to give the user the main options again to sign up or log in. And I'll add a backslash N. And one last thing I forgot is I need to global the variable U, and I need to global the variable P. And basically what global does, it allows me to use these variables U and P outside of this if function. So after I global this, I think I would also need to global answer over it down here. So global answer. I'm not sure you need to do this. Yes, I get an error, so I guess you don't have to do this. So this is pretty much the code. So now let's see if this code works. So I'll run the code. And it will ask me to select an option. So I want to sign up, create a username, password, and then it will display account created successfully. And after that, we want to log in. Enter username we just created and enter password, and if we get the password wrong, it will display password incorrect until we get the password correct. So I'll put in the correct password, and after that we're logged in. So one last thing we need to do is after the user's logged in, we need to tell him that he's logged in by printing, let's say, logged in. So up here I'll create a function, and the function name will be logged in. And in this function, I can print logged in. And if you want anything else to happen when the user is logged in, you could add it in this function over here. So after I created the function, I need to call the function down here. Logged in. And now let's run the code for the second time. And I'll sign up, create a username, create a password, and I want to log in, enter username, and enter user password. And after this, it will display logged in. So just to make this a little bit more interesting, so what I want to do here is after the user's logged in, it will give him an option, let's say, to show how much money he has in his bank. So what we could do here is we could print, let's say, show amount of dollars. So I'll do this. And then we want to input, and we want to get the response from the user. So we'll leave this empty, and over here we'll put this in a variable, and we'll name the variable, let's say, answer one, because we can't have two of the same variables. And then after this we could do if answer one is equal to S, and if it is, so we want to print, let's say, a random number of money. So let's say you have $1 million. Okay, and after you do this, we could say else. So if the user doesn't want to show the amount of money he has, so we could just break. And what break does, break will just end up the code. Okay, so if I run the code, I get an error, and the error is you can't use break outside of a loop. So I'll just create a random loop. So just while true. And while true means this while loop will run forever. Okay, so now I'll run the code. So S, create a username, create a password, and then after that, I'll log in. I'll enter the username I just created, user password, and then now I want to show the amount of money I have. So S, and then it will print you have $1 million. So if I run this again, and I'll log in, and I don't want to show the amount of money. So if I put in any other random letter, it will just end up the code as you see. So that's pretty much it for this tutorial. If you enjoyed this tutorial, don't forget to like, share this video with friends, and subscribe to stay updated on other fun tutorials coming soon. Thanks for watching.